Hey guys, Eric Tarr here for theproaudiofiles.com. As of the making of this video, very recently, Empirical Labs released their first ever native software plugin. It's called Arouser. You're looking at it right here. You can download a free 15-day demo of this plugin off of their website. As far as I can tell, it's not even for sale yet. I assume it will be in the near future. This is probably some kind of final beta version to help them work out the last of the bugs. As long as you got an iLock 2, it's compatible with AAX, VST, and AU plugin formats on both Mac and Windows. This is a highly anticipated software to finally have running inside of the box natively. For a long time, Empirical Labs, I guess they had only really had a plugin on the Universal Audio platform where they licensed their brand over to them. As a company, they've actually been outspoken for a while about how they didn't think modeling and digital signal processing was up to the level to really capture what's going on with their hardware. Their hardware is beloved by audio engineers, widely used for saturation and compression. They've got the Fatso, they've got the Distressor. People love it. It has its own kind of sound, own kind of features and controls. You can use it for drums, vocals, guitars, just about everything, and it does its own kind of unique and cool thing. So it's awesome now for those of us that like to work inside of the box with software to finally have a plugin that at least gets us most of the way there and sounds pretty good. I'm excited because it seems like Empirical Labs, they put in the time, they put in the effort, and they're willing to put their name on this and say, you know what, this is going to give you what you're looking for. When you think of Empirical Labs, this is going to get you where you want to be. So this isn't an exact one-for-one replica of the Distressor, the Fatso. It's got similar kinds of features and controls, but it's not exactly going to be one-for-one parameters that you can set to do the same thing as a Distressor. For the most part, it's a compressor within features. It's also got some saturation going on too. So, you know, try it out for yourself. See what you think. There's lots of other great demos online too with people trying it out on drums and guitars and all that kind of stuff. When I opened it up and I started testing it out, I started wanting to get into the nitty gritty and understand what's going on. You know, what are these kind of unique features all about that give it its characteristic sound? You know, for the most part, you've got controls for a compressor like the input and the output that help you set the level of the signal driving into the threshold of the compressor. Then you've got attack and release that you can set. Pick the ratio, everything from 1:1 up to extreme settings. Got gain reduction meters up here. You've got lots of sidechain controls, whether you want to roll off the low frequencies or kind of enhance something in the mid-range or even upper mid-range to really drive into the compressor. You've got the wet-dry mix for parallel compression in here. Then you've got these other kind of unique controls like attack modification. You can turn it off or turn it up, whatever that is supposed to mean, and also soft clipping. So as soon as I started playing around with it, I started to want to analyze what these things are all about and understand, you know, what is this attack modification? Is this feature giving me something that's different from other compressors that I've already got? So in this video, I'm going to focus on analyzing this parameter, give you a better idea about what it's going to do. And then my next video, a follow-up one, I'm going to analyze some things about the soft clipping and see what's going on with that there too. So the best way to do this is actually to kind of rip off a video that I've done in the past to analyze compressor plugins, where I use a specific test signal that you're seeing right here. It's just the 1 kHz tone and has two different levels. I pick these levels specifically so that I can analyze the characteristics of a compressor. This first part of the signal I set to be above the threshold of the compressor, so I can watch what happens to the signal when it first jumps up above the threshold of the compressor, and then I can analyze the attack characteristics. Then I've got this part of the signal over here where the signal is intentionally below the threshold. You know, if you have any questions about how this exercise works, definitely check out some of my other videos. It's great to see and look side by side, you know, what is 1176 like? What is the Arouser like? What is, you know, other kinds of software compressors like the DBX160 and so on. You can see, you know, what is it that gives one sound versus another one? Is that what you're hearing? Are you hearing those subtleties and the differences between, you know, different kinds of compressors? So what I'm going to do here is run this signal through this compressor, look at attack characteristics, look at release characteristics, and print this signal over here on this other track down below called the output. So I'm going to record on this one, then what I'll do is just adjust some of these basic settings to begin with, like set a pretty fast attack and a pretty fast release and see what this is all about. So I'll print this one down here below and then start to adjust some of the parameters. All right, so you can hear that it's just a 1 kilohertz tone at a couple different levels, and look at what the effect is that is controlling the amplitude. I'm going to mute this one because it'll get pretty annoying very quickly. So this compressor has a very fast attack. You know, this is on the order of what you would think of with an 1176. This isn't even the fastest settings that I've got. It is immediately squashing that transient. Very fast release too. I could even shorten it up more and see what that's all about. Almost instantaneous for the most part, as far as compressors are concerned. So then the interesting thing is to back some of these things off. Let's look maybe around 300-400 milliseconds for the release, and maybe closer up here to around like 15 milliseconds of attack. So let's print this one and watch what the difference is. So look at the slope now for the attack and the release, right? This is not a linear sort of thing. It's a, you know, exponential kind of decay going on in each of these things. I think this resembles kind of like an opto sort of compressor where it's curved like this. Attack, right? Even on the longest setting, 40 milliseconds, let's have a look at what that looks like. So 40 milliseconds, what I can do is undo and go back. That's 15 milliseconds, and I'll go forward now, and that's 40 milliseconds. So it also seems like even with the longest attack, there's also something going on with the ratio or the amount of compression, at least at this limiting state. So what this is going to bring me to is, let's look at attack modification, what that's all about. So here, let's go back and I'm going to type in. One of the cool things about this plugin is you can do perfect recall by typing in the numbers here rather than trying to pick and line up the knob here. So that's nice to have. I'm going to stick with the 10 to 1 ratio. I'm going to increase this attack modification. So I'll start out and print a fresh, brand new one here to look at. Here's a 15 milliseconds. All right. Now let's turn up the attack modification and see what this is all about. So the attack modification, if I switch back and forth, what it's going to allow me to do is have a much longer attack. As it's described in here in the help, if I click on this one, it might be difficult to see. It's the attack mod is a unique proprietary control that lengthens the initial attack time, especially on transients. So for drums, what this is going to allow you to do is kind of set your compression that you like, but if you want a little bit more you know, transient coming through to give your drums more energy, just turn up the attack modification a little bit. Now, this isn't extreme control. There are other plugins you can come across, like the H comp that has an attack sort of thing that does its own unique weird thing to the attack characteristics. This one, it still has a similar kind of shape here, at least for this kind of input signal. So not a whole lot dramatic going on. What I can compare this one to, this is the longer one. Let's step this up all the way to 40. Let's compare the one where I've got the longest attack modification. I cranked it all the way up here to 10 on 15 milliseconds. Let's compare that with 40 with zero going on right here. So this is 40 milliseconds. This is 15 milliseconds with attack modification turned all the way up. It's a subtle difference, right? But this is where the attack modification actually allows you, if you turn it up enough, it's going to give you something completely different. So here, you can see that the attack modification really gives you some control to lengthen the amount of attack that occurs. So if this was a drum hit, you could allow that transient to peek through without being squashed too much. So that's all I'm going to show you here in this first video. I'm going to post in a follow-up video where I go in and analyze some interesting characteristics about the soft clipping. Hopefully this video gives you a better idea about the behavior and controls of the Arouser plugin. You know, download this one for yourself, try it out, and really hear how it sounds on more musical instruments. Till next time, take care, guys.